This is the COAR Children's Village. COAR stands for the Community of St. Oscar A. Romero. COAR is a school for 1,000 children, pre-kindergarten through 12th grade. COAR is a home for 30 to 50 children who cannot live with their families due to neglect, abuse, or the extreme violence of their neighborhoods. COAR has a clinic, vocational training, a large chapel, and many other resources for the entire impoverished community. Thank you for watching our mission appeal. 100% of the funds we receive through this appeal will go to the COAR Children's Village for house mothers, teachers, food, medicine, and shelter, all the things it takes to raise joyful and resilient children. And it doesn't take much. $10 buys school supplies for a month. $25 feeds a child for a week. $1,000 feeds a child for a year. There is an impact for every gift you can give. You can learn more at our website, coarpeacemission.org. COAR is located in El Salvador in Central America. For the past 10 years, El Salvador has been among the deadliest countries in the world because of criminal gangs who prey on El Salvador's extreme poverty. The gangs recruit teenagers and children who have no protection, no hope, and no alternative. Through COAR, you can give these children an alternative. The COAR school is also our parish school. It is one of the best schools in the region. We offer traditional studies as well as vocational training in health, hospitality, and farming. We offer entrepreneurial workshops and internships. Our graduates go on to university as well as vocational training as their abilities allow. But most importantly, we remain open when gang violence closes the schools around us. COAR has a security wall and armed guards that provide the only safe space that many of our children know. COAR's home for foster care children is our most important program. Up to 50 children live together in groups of 5 to 10 in small houses with a house mother. The children eat together, do homework together, garden together, pray together, play together, and learn to take care of their home and each other. Yes, that includes chores. They clean the house and wash their own clothes by hand. The children write letters to their sponsors in North America. They have field trips to important cultural sites. They participate in the school band, sports, dance, and other cultural programs. But crucially, they have psychologists and other professionals to help them with the very real trauma they carry. Among these faces that you have seen in this video are children who have been abused, left to scrounger living in the streets, trafficked, or abandoned. For their safety and their dignity, we cannot single them out. But our success is that they all look like happy and healthy children. That's what your support achieves. COAR succeeds because it has been a place for traumatized children to heal since 1980, when it was founded as a war orphanage. Our namesake, St. Oscar Romero, was the Archbishop of the capital city as unrest escalated in the 1970s. As the unrest grew, he was especially moved by the poorest of his people, who were targets of atrocities and massacres, and so he opened refugee camps for people fleeing the violence. He asked North Americans to help in the refugee crisis. Among those were members of the Cleveland Diocese, who had been serving in parishes in El Salvador since 1964. Those missionaries saw orphaned children in the camps who were sick, hungry, and terrified. They brought them back to their parish and named their center after Archbishop Oscar Romero, and COAR was born. Archbishop Romero was murdered while saying Mass on March 24, 1980. Later that same year, on December 2nd, four North American churchwomen were also murdered. Two were members of the Cleveland Mission Team, Ursuline sister Dorothy Kazel, and a young lay volunteer, Jean Donovan. They were targeted because of their work with refugees. By early 1981, COAR had hundreds of children. It became a separate mission from the parish in order to protect it from those murders and the political danger they represented. In the same way, the original supporters of the Cleveland missionaries who founded COAR formed an independent Catholic charity named the COAR Peace Mission to raise funds and awareness in North America. I am one of those supporters. Sister Dorothy Kazel was one of my high school teachers. I am one of thousands of people who continue to support the COAR Children's Village, and we invite you to join us. We need you to join us. COAR is administered by the Archdiocese of San Salvador. Our children know the example of St. Romero, their Archbishop and Cardinal, and the full support of the institutional and caring church. As a Catholic mission, our appeal must come from the gospel. Because we are socially distanced from speaking in your parish, our appeal is not tied to a particular Sunday gospel this year. But pick any gospel this summer, loaves and fishes, discovering the pearl of great price. They are stories of discerning what is true. They are stories of compassion, understanding, and healing. And we are called to participate. If we offer our meager gifts to God, our prayers, certainly, but also our $5 and $2, our $20 and $100, He will multiply it beyond anything we can do on our own. This is true of any support you give to any of the thousands of Catholic missions. It is certainly true at COAR. We welcome your help in raising the next generation of healthy, educated, and resilient children in El Salvador. You can learn more at our website, coarpeacemission.org. Thank you.